You know Tank very well. Obviously, you know Devin. If they fight, who wins and why?
They fight. I mean, of course, you know I'm robbing my man's Tank. You know, I definitely got robbing him, and it'll be another great fight for the boxing fans. And I would definitely be a fan watching it and excited to see that.
Okay, you sparred both. Who is faster?
I want to say Tank. Tank is fast. Tank is smaller, so he's a little bit.
Okay,
faster.
Who hit harder?
Okay, obviously Tank.
Listen, I gotta ask those questions. Who had better footwork? They both have footwork.
I don't know. They both equally as far as footwork. They both, you know, they both understand, you know, distance and range, and they both know how to use their feet.
Okay, boxing well. Boxing IQ.
Boxing, both is
Tank's very smart, and so it looks Devin looks like he's like that too. So
yeah, so they both right there.
Better defense.
Better defense. I would say it was harder, maybe a little harder to hit Tank.
It doesn't get credit for the defense because he gets all the knockouts. Okay, Tank and Teal, what happens in that one?
Like I said, I'm gonna be biased, Ellie. I ain't gonna lie to you because Tank is one of my closest friends.
Okay.
Outside of boxing, so I would pick Tank over anybody but myself. So. You know, like anybody but myself or Shakur, like those are like my closest friends. So those are like
people. So what are you gonna do when Tank fights Shakur? Use my slogan: the fans are the winners.
Beat it as a fan. I think that you know, Shakur's last performance, a lot of people kind of fell asleep on him because of that out and how he performed. But a lot of people don't really know what De Los Santos brings to the table. I spoxed De Los Santos, and I feel like De Los Santos is extremely dangerous. And I've told Shakur that coming in before the fight, and Shakur had to do what he had to do to pull away and get the victory. And I honestly would want to see De Los Santos and Tank fight. I think that would be a great fight because people don't really perceive what De Los Santos bring. But I don't think that would be a fight. That would be a fight where Tank would really have to use his mind because De Los Santos has big punching power. Like he's way better than Rhodey.
Speaking of Rolly and Ryan, looks like they're fighting next. Who do you like?
Ooh, I don't know. I would say Rolly probably can pull away with it, the W, just from looking from their sparring. But it's sparring, and Ryan does have a lot of advantages. He got the height, he got the speed, and he does got power, and Rolly don't have the best chin. So I can see a world where Rolly probably can win the fight, but I would probably give it to Ryan because Ryan experience and his physical attributes.
By the way, I just read this. The California State Athletic Commission said that Devin was 165 on fight night.
Damn. No way. Hell no.
Yeah, they said Regis was 156.
Crazy. Yeah, I don't rehydrate up to 160, 165. Biggest I probably got before a fight, maybe like 156. Yeah, like 156.
Yeah, no, it's not healthy. It's not healthy to gain too much. And if it's more than 20%, the commission won't even let you fight.
If you rehydrate too big, they won't let you.
Yes, fight. If you rehydrate more than 20% of your weight, they won't let you fight. I've seen it happen when they say sorry. California, they do.
California. I was about to say, okay, yeah. different places don't check you.
Right, but the sanctioning bodies, Richardson, like the WBC, they check, they weigh you. They weigh you a month out, 2 weeks out, a week out. They weigh you on fight day. They have a very strict protocol about weights, about gaining weight, because if you dehydrate too much and then gain too much, you can have a concussion. There's a lot of things that go into it where it's dangerous for you to make.
I didn't know you rehydrate. 165, right?
Yeah.
That's big.
60, of course, yes.
20. He did look big. He looked really big in there for Regis. But I think that was a smart. He had to do that because Regis is a big puncher. So if that was me, if I was fighting Regis, I would have rehydrated as big as I could possibly get.
And he won clearly. Yeah, unlike the Loma fight, which I thought Loma won, this one Devin won clearly. Wasn't even, you know, a question. Obviously, he won. And it'll be interesting because Sandow Martin is the mandatory. How does he do with Sandow?
But I've been through that. Regis wasn't that guy. Like Regis is a cool guy. He looked like a good guy. Regis talk a good game. But I've been telling people long time ago that Regis never fought nobody on that level. Josh Taylor never fought nobody on that level. Josh Taylor beat Jose Ramirez, and I think the scorecard was 116-112, but or 116-111. But he dropped Jose Ramirez twice and still got the scorecard. So that obviously showed that he really wasn't dominating the fight. And Jose Ramirez was Josh Taylor's best one, in my opinion. I just feel like Regis. I just feel like when I was in there with Jose Zepeda, like, all respect to Jose Zepeda, he gave me an opportunity. He's a great fighter. But I just feel like when I was in there with Jose Zepeda, I just seen how green Jose Zepeda was. And I felt like him and Regis was in a good fight. So I just, that kind of gauged me where Regis boxing was at. And you know, it was always talks about, you know, Regis, people tell me, seeing Regis box in the gym with fighters that I know, and would tell me how he wasn't really that good. So I had the fight picked. Once I seen Bill at the fight at Regis last fight, we all knew that Regis only had a puncher's chance. Like,
Gervonta Davis is a superstar. Superstar. He's bigger than boxing. You've seen it up close. You know what I'm talking about. He can't take two steps without getting mopped. Devin Haney, that's not the case. He's a good fighter. He's talented, but he's not that rock star. Why do people get mad at me when I say that? Like, what am I saying that's not true?
I don't know. No, you're right. For sure, we all know Tank is the biggest star. Devin knows that himself, that Tank is the biggest star. But I think that Devin is crossing over to where he's kind of like a Gervonta on like a, he's like a watered down Gervonta as far as like celebrity and appeal. Like, I feel like he can bring that same. He brings that, like, that. He tries to bring the same vibe, I feel like, but I feel like Tank is, like, you know, that's Tank. Like, Tank is a real star. Like, people, it's just, Tank just have that it factor that.
It's organic. It's not manual. It's organic. That's who he is. It's not.
I feel like Tank would have been a star, like, in, like, whatever route he took. Whether he was signed to Floyd or not. Like, I feel like Floyd definitely gave him that boost and gave him that, you know, that kickstart. But I feel like Tank was signed with anybody, Eddie Hearn, anybody, like, Tank would have been a huge star. Just his story, his presence, and just how he fights, anybody's, is just appealing.
Yeah, like I called him when I first saw him next Mike Tyson. Obviously he's not Mike Tyson, but people got the point, the big punching power, the frame, you know.
Yeah for sure.
So let me ask you a couple more really quick. Benavidez or Canelo, who do you like?
I like Benavidez a lot. I'm not gonna lie, like, Canelo is an OG with so much experience. I like Benavidez a lot. Canelo's an OG, but I just feel like Benavidez is a bad, like, motherfucker. Like, I really, like, I've been like the Benavidez, but he making me like him more and more because I think the it factor to me about Benavidez is his age. Like, people forget to seem like he's in the same class as, like, me, Devin, Tank, Shakur. Like, he's in that same class, but I feel like, he's special. Like, I like him. I would back him to be Canelo. Like, I would want him to be Canelo just for the younger generation.
Obviously, you want the Haney fight, and I hope you get it. It's a major fight. You've proven yourself, and you have history and everything. But if they go a different route, how does he do with Sandor Martin? Because the WBC says that's the mandatory.
He beat Sandor Martin easily.
Why easy? Sandor's, he beat Mikey, and he did good with Regis? Oh, no, to Teofimo, not Regis, sorry.
Devin is smarter than Mikey Garcia, and he's smarter than Teofimo, because I know they got the Teofimo's on top, but Devin is a better fighter than the fighters that you name.
So okay.
He'll win it.
What about if he moves up to 47 and fights Mario Barrios for the interim, what do you think?
He beats Mario Barrios too. He's a better fighter.
Okay, him and Boots Ennis?
Oh, no, he can't beat Boots. Boots is too much for him.
Bill is
stylistically, Devin, that I don't see Devin putting himself in harm's way to take that shit. What Boots is, the shit that Boots is gonna send his way, Devin's gonna have to get around that and get in position to even make it competitive. And I don't see him like being able to withstand that.
Okay, what about Boots and Crawford?
I like the fight a lot. Crawford is the greatest of our generation, and I just feel like Boots never been in there with somebody like that, and I just feel like Crawford is too smart.
All right, give me three opponents you'd love to fight. So let's start. You and Haney, what happens when you guys share the ring?
We're all gonna see that I'm the better fighter. I'm the better boxer in the sport of boxing. I'm the better fighter. So I like to fight Haney. I like to fight all the champions, you know, whoever's the champion.
Matias, like, Rowley, and Teofimo.
Yeah, all of them.
Matias, no one's, Richardson, no one's rushing to fight Matias. Why?
Because Matias is a dangerous fighter, and he doesn't have a name. You fight Matias, the fight ain't gonna be that big. It's just gonna be another fight. You fight somebody like Teofimo, you fight somebody like Devin Haney. The world is, you can, that's a big win. If you beat a guy like Matias, or you lose to a guy like Matias, it doesn't do that much for you. Besides, you just won a world title. It's cool. You put, it's like putting yourself in line. You're kind of still putting yourself in line to get a big fight like Devin or Teofimo.
How would you do with, let's say, Matias? I mean, are you as mandatory?
No, I'm not as mandatory.
Are you somebody's mandatory? Because you're ranked pretty high.
I'm thinking the highest I'm ranked in is for the WBC and the WBO. For TO or WBO.
Okay, well, hopefully you get those fights. Those are big fights.
Right.
I don't know what they're planning to do, but you got to stay busy. You're a fighter, right? You just fought not too long ago.
Yeah. And we're looking to be back again in March, so...
All right.
So yeah, hopefully by the fight after that, we're definitely in title contention. Or you know, they gonna keep that WBA over there with Rolly. So you know, even if I get ranked in that, they ain't gonna come nowhere near me. So I won't even mention Rolly name.
Rolly's gonna fight Ryan, like I said. Okay, last thing, Gervonta Davis. Who does he fight next? If you were a betting man.
I think he should fight Frank Martin.
It's a big fight. Frank's one of the best in the world. 35, coming off a series of wins. He's 20-0, I think 12 knockouts, something like that.
I think that'd be a perfect fight for Frank. Because Frank, he's a lot older too. And obviously, that's a big money fight. And I don't think he should be wasting his time trying to, you know, build himself any more. If he got himself in position to fight a big fight like Tank, he should jump on that opportunity.
All right, there you have it, guys. Richardson Hitchens, any message to your fans in New York and around the world? What do you tell them?
I want to tell all the boxing fans, I'm the truth. Keep watching, paying attention to my career. I'm the best at 140, the best in boxing. And soon everybody going to get to see it, man. I'm just laying low, waiting for my opportunity, waiting for my chance. And when I blow, it's gonna blow the world up.
On the phone with us, one of the biggest names in the 140 division. They don't always give him the credit. They don't always give him a chance, but he comes in and he wins in grand fashion. I'm talking Richardson Hitchens, former Olympian, now boxing star. Richardson, how you feeling?
I'm feeling good, Ellie. Thank God.
So you called out Devin Haney. Tell us a little about it. What happens when you and Devin fight?
I think with me and Devin fight, it's going to be a great fight for the fans. I think that boxing world is really gonna see where I'm at as far as skill, as far as my competitive nature, and just everything's gonna come out who I really am in a fight like that, and vice versa with Devin. I think that boxing a lot is an entertainment sport, and a lot of people don't really can dissect a lot of situations to see why would a fight like me and Devin Haney would be a great fight for the sport of boxing. But I know, and I'm pretty sure Devin knows, so when it happens, it's going to be great.
Do you believe he will take a risky fight like you and fight you, or will he look like maybe to fight an easier fight?
I think that the smartest move is to fight an easier fight. I don't know. I mean, he has a great management team, and I don't know. I think fighting me is real risky. Me and Devin shared numerous rounds together, so we both know what... He knows what I bring to the table. I know what he brings to the table. And like I said, we shared numerous rounds together as young kids and as upcoming professionals. So we, like I said, we know what each other can do. So I think, we'll just have to wait and see.
So talk about the sparring. What was it like? Like, who got the best of who, or how was the situation?
I felt like majority of the times I sparred Devin, I always got the best of it. You can always kind of tell like who was the better fighter. Devin is real competitive though, and been in the gym since a kid, so it was never just a cakewalk or none of that. But I just felt like I've just always got the better of the work. Let me just narrow it down a little bit more. I always felt like being in the ring with Devin that I was the better fighter. I always, every time, even from his brother, I don't know his brother's name, but I remember like. this brother just giving me ultimate respect after he seen me and Devin work. Because, you know, we sparked our beat for like a week on a Danny Jacobs and Canelo fight. And I guess his brother didn't really, you know, he didn't know who I was. So when he seen my talent with Floyd, he seen like what was going on in the ring. They're like, damn, this kid, like, I don't know this kid, but he's special. And I mean, anybody that knows me or seen me box before, they don't know that I'm not just talking or just trying to promote myself. Everybody know what I bring to the table, right? And if you see me box, you know I'm a special fighter.
No, absolutely. I've seen you spar a lot of big names, and you're super talented. Like I said, you're like, I would say, they don't give you your respect yet. You'll get it once you have a major victory, but in the meantime, you're kind of below the radar, but the talent's there. When I interviewed Virgil Ortiz Sr. the other day, who wins it all out of all the 140s, he says he's picking you as one of the guys to win it all.
Right. Yeah, I know the Virgil, me and Virgil boxing the amateurs. Virgil's another great fighter. He's actually one of my favorite fighters in the 147 division, you know. And I mean, like I said, we grew up together. We know, we all know what we all bring to the table, because at the end of the day, we all come up from the same pedigree. So, I mean, I'm glad that he, you know, had that to say about me.
Yeah, Virgil's 19-19 knockouts. He's fighting January 6th. Do you know when you're fighting next or who you're fighting, or it's all up in the air right now?
I'm supposed to be fighting in March. I think talks is somebody maybe like Liam Carroll or, you know, Jack Catterall or somebody like
that. Those are big names. Those are big fights. One from Australia, one from England. They're coming off wins.
Yeah, I think that would be a huge fight and a huge, you know, it'll bring a lot of more attention to me and do a lot for my career. I feel like, honestly, like I said, I've been telling a lot of people, I won't get tested unless you put me against the elites. And I don't feel like Jack Catterall or Liam Parra are on my level, but we'll have to see when we get in the ring.
Yeah, no, you want to be tested. You want to show people how good you can do. All right, there you have it. Make sure to follow him everywhere on social media at Richardson Hitchens. Eli Sekback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Eli Sekback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com.
I'm Eli Sekback, reporting.